Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will not be dealing with the lead editorial, rather I will be dealing with section 377. Now this is very important from mains examination point of view. This relates to ethics paper. This also has a relevancy with general studies mains examination paper 2. Now first of all, in this editorial we will be learning what this section is about. And this is the first important thing that we'll be learning. And the second important thing that we'll be learning will be about the verdict of the court. Court's verdict. The court has pronounced various verdicts, and the two important verdicts about section 377 are, first one is NAS Foundation. And the second one is Suresh Kumar Kaushal case versus NAS Foundation. And thirdly, we'll be understanding why this section 377 is under discussion again because of this right to privacy. So we'll be discussing all these dimensions in today's editorial, today's class. Now before we understand 377 and what it entails, what it contains, and why it is under so much of discussion, we need to understand the history of India. Now the Indian history, the ancient phase of Indian history and the medieval phase of Indian history, we have numerous evidences which suggests that Indians during that phase, they were not against the sexual minorities. They were not against the sexual intercourse that is unnatural. See, it is the humans that have actually given this name, that have actually given this characterization of natural sex and unnatural sex. Now, natural sex is something that is believed to a sex which leads to the birth of a child, that leads to the progression in the society, progression by way of birth. And unnatural sex, that is not the vaginal sex, is believed to be, that is what is we categorize it as, unnatural sex. Now when it comes to the unnatural sex, the Indian religion, it was not against this unnatural sex practices. We have the evidences of how the people resorting to this unnatural sex were respected during the historical phase. We have the example in the form of Khajuraho temple. We have the example in the form of Madhubani temple. And we have numerous texts written like Patanjali's grammar. Now all these things reflect that the unnatural sex was something that was not prohibited, something that was accepted in the Indian society during the ancient phase of the Indian history. But of late, when the Britishers came, they had actually questioned this unnatural sexual activity because this was something that was not in consonance with their religion. That is the Christian ethics. So it was not in consonance with the Christian ethics. So in order to justify these Christian ethics, the British, they had inserted this section 377 in the Indian Penal Code. So now anybody who will be indulging in unnatural carnal intercourse will be categorized as a criminal, and he or she can be put to jail for the entire life term. So there is a provision of life imprisonment, there is a provision of a jail of at least, the minimum is 10 years and the maximum is life imprisonment plus the fine. Now this aspect has been challenged since India got its independence. Now because why this aspect has been challenged after independence? Now when it comes to India, India's constitutional vision is that India wants to respect the minorities. Minorities, the language and religious minorities are mentioned in Article 29 and 30. But in essence, for what the Indian Constitution really stands for, it must also respect the sexual minorities. So this is actually the ethos and the vision and the spirit of the Indian Constitution. But Section 377 is not in sync with what the Indianness stands for. So this was challenged by NAS Foundation. Now what is NAS Foundation? It's an NGO, New Delhi based NGO. This is challenged. It is working in the field of HIV/AIDS for the rehabilitation of the patients who have been afflicted by this HIV/AIDS. The NAS Foundation had challenged this in Delhi High Court, and Delhi High Court had given a pronouncement in this NAS Foundation case that this Section 377 is not in consonance with the spirit of the Indian Constitution. It is against Article 14, it is against Article 19, it is against Article 21. So in order to promote equality, it is important that sexual minorities should also be given space in the Indian society. Now this was the pronouncement of the Delhi High Court. Now this very decision was challenged in Suresh Kaushal case. So in the new case that we had after this NAS Foundation case of the Delhi High Court, this verdict was challenged in the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court in Suresh Kumar Kaushal case has upheld the Section 377. Now what is the meaning of upholding this Section 377? Now upholding means that this section was pronounced to be correct and in sync and in consonance with the spirit of the Indian Constitution. Now how this article has been upheld by the Suresh Kumar Kaushal case? There are three justifications given by the Supreme Court in Suresh Kumar Kaushal case. Now the first justification that was given by the court was that they are not going to judge this case from the perspective of severability. Now what is the meaning of doctrine of severability? Now we also have the pedophiles. Now, who all are pedophiles that do sex with the children? This is a community in the minority, and it would be handy to actually go against the people who are actually pedophiles. So this Section 377 would be good for such people, but this is not good for the people who are entering into sexual activity on a consensual basis, voluntarial basis. So it is hitting against the freedom of Article 19, 21 and 14. And even in Menaka Gandhi case, the personal liberty, as in the Menaka Gandhi case, Supreme Court has pronounced that the personal liberty under Article 21 should be given widest of the interpretations. They should not be the narrower of the interpretations. But in this very case of Suresh Kumar Kaushal case, Supreme Court has said that the doctrine of severability should not be applied to this case. And the second important thing, there is a rule of reading down. There are basically three rules when it comes to reading the judgments by the Supreme Court or the judiciary. Reading in, reading out, and reading down. Now, what is the meaning of reading down? Reading down means you actually don't go into the nitty-gritties of a particular law. Rather, you view a particular law from the perspective of the parent law or the constitution. Now, according to the judges in the Supreme Court in Suresh Kumar Kaushal case, the Nas Foundation case was decided by following this principle of rule of reading down, and this is something that is not right. This was the criticism. See, judiciary must interpret the law as the law is. They should not be reading in, they should not be reading out, they should not be reading down. So in this very case, the reading that was given by the judges in the Nas Foundation case in the Delhi High Court, this was not ethical from judicial perspective point of view. So according to Suresh Kumar Kaushal case, this rule of reading down should not have been applied, and this was the reason they had upheld this section 377. And moreover, in this case of Suresh Kumar Kaushal case, Supreme Court had believed in the principle of constitutional validity. Now, what is this principle of constitutional validity? This principle of constitutional validity means that there is an element of presumption. There is an element of presumption that if any law that is in existence in India now and which began during the British era, if that particular law has not been challenged till now, in that case, the presumption will be there that particular case, that the validity of that particular case will be upheld. Now, according to Suresh Kumar Kaushal case, abhi tak ye presume kiya ja raha tha ki ye section 377 it is in consonance with the constitution, so isko challenge nahi karna hai. So these were the three logics given by the Supreme Court in Suresh Kumar Kaushal case, that they are not going to apply doctrine of severability, and the Delhi court had applied this rule of reading down, this was wrong, and this presumption of constitutional validity, that this was valid till now and why it is being challenged now, it was presumed to be correct. Now let me tell you one important thing. Now when it comes to the section 377, this was inserted by the British, but when it comes to the law in England these days, they have actually done away with this unnatural intercourse through an act in 1967 in England. So England may, at this particular time, in the present time, you don't have a law that prohibits this unnatural sex. Now why this? Why we are talking so much about the section 377? Now why we are talking about the section 377 primarily? Because now we have this right to privacy. Now this right to privacy recently has been upheld by the Supreme Court. And when it comes to this unnatural sex or the voluntary intercourse between the two people, maybe the girls, maybe the boys, in that case, whatever they are doing, it is their private affair. It is the matter of the privacy. So now it is believed that the Suresh Kumar Kaushal case might be challenged and this section 377 might be done away with from the law books of India, from the IPC. So this is all this, what this entire thing is about, the section 377. Now you can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.